Hello everyone. In this CapCut tutorial, I'm going to show you how to edit this video and turn it into a movie scene of a fantasy world like this one. Alright, so the first step here is to create or get a sky image that will be used to replace the sky in the video. One key thing to take note in choosing the image is that, since this is a daytime scene, the sky image should have a color tone close to that of the sky in the video, so that later they will blend seamlessly. And also to ensure that image quality doesn't degrade in the video, it's strongly recommended to use an image having a resolution of at least the same as the video's resolution. For this exercise, I will use this image, which is 1920 by 1080 pixels, which nicely matches the video resolution. Once the image is ready, add it to the timeline above the main track and make its duration the same as that of the main video. Then adjust its vertical position if necessary. Now show the video masking options and properties and apply the horizontal mask. Then adjust the mask's position to be slightly above the horizon in the video. And if necessary, adjust its angle such that it's parallel with the horizon. And finally, to blend it nicely with the skyline in the video, increase the feather accordingly. Alright, as you can see here, the skyline already looks seamless and nice, but the color tone of the sky doesn't quite blend with the color tone of the land. To fix this problem, and to add an atmosphere of a fantasy world, we are going to play with the color adjustment of both the video and the image. So first, select the video and show its adjustment panel. Then go to the color adjustment and adjust the temperature, the hue, and the saturation values. A positive temperature will give a warm color tone, like in the late afternoon or before the sunset, while a negative temperature will give a cool day light tone. Since the sun in this scene is low, I will give it a warm color tone. And then to amplify the green color of the coconut trees, I will adjust the hue towards green and saturate it. You may also play with the lightness settings if desired. For example, here I'm just gonna increase the brightness slightly. Alright, once you're happy with it, repeat these color adjustment steps on the sky image so that it blends nicely with the video. For this sky image, I will also reduce the shadow slightly. Alright, so the main part of the scene is done. Now let's add the two flying birds to make the scene more alive. For this purpose, I will use stickers. So I will add this flying bird sticker. Set its entry time to the scene at 1.5 seconds into the video, and its duration to about 9 seconds. After that, resize it according to the desired perceived initial distance of the bird from the camera. Now to make the bird appear flying from the right side of the screen and then disappear on the left side of the screen, we will have to animate the position and the scale of the bird sticker. To do that, first place the sticker somewhere hidden outside the frame. And now with the playhead still positioned at the start of the bird clip, use this frame as the start keyframe of the flying bird animation. After that, move the playhead to the end of the bird clip. Then simply add a minus sign to the sticker's X position and adjust the Y position accordingly. We may also increase its size a little bit to give an impression that the bird is getting closer to the camera as it flies to the left. And then to add the second bird, simply copy the bird clip and place it above the first one but a few frames behind. Alright, the next step will be adding the 1.5 second letterbox animation in the beginning of the video. But since our video consists of multiple video tracks, we cannot simply apply a mirror mask on the main video clip to achieve it. Instead, we will have to use two auxiliary black clips, placed one on top of the other above the sky clip. Then we will apply horizontal mask to both of them but with different angles, such that the bottom one is like the mirror image of the top one. After that, with the playhead positioned at the start of the black clips, set the top clip's mask's Y position to -1, and then add the current frame as the start keyframe of the letterbox animation. Repeat these steps on the second black clip, but with Y position set to 1. Now move the playhead to the end of the black clips, and then adjust the mask's Y positions accordingly. Alright, now we've come to the last step of this video editing, which is adding the music. So I'll open the audio library panel and search for Cinematic Inspiring. I will use this audio track and select the part that I think is most suitable for this scene. I will also add a 1.5 second fade in effect to this audio track to make it in sync with the letterbox opening animation. Alright, it's all set. Now let's play the video to see the result. Okay, so that's how easy it is to make a Hollywood movie-like video in CapCut. I hope you find this tutorial useful, and thank you for watching.